Welcome Ranjini Sharma for Trinity Mirror News. The headlines. Ban on plastics impacts small businesses, traders in Nilgiris. Indians again top foreign property investors in Dubai. 5 minor detained for attack on Swiss couple, raids on to nab others. Australia edge out India juniors 4-3 in hockey. News in detail. Ban on plastics impacts small businesses, traders in Nilgiri. The ban announced on plastic packing across the Nilgiris has largely been welcomed by residents and activists, whereas small business owners and merchants say that they have been severely impacted by the ban because of a lack of alternatives to plastic packing. Restaurant, store and meat stall owners said that though the ban has made things difficult, they have been able to find alternatives to plastic like the use of banana leaves to pack meat and also in use as plates at bakeries and coffee shops. Some restaurants have even begun insisting on customers bringing their own containers to buy food parcels. Python rescued from village in Coimbatore. Forest Department officials rescued an Indian python from a village near Puruvampatti. The snake was later released inside reserve forest. According to Forest Department official, the python measuring 8 feet was found on the side of a stream in a patta land lying close to forest near Chemmedu. It was first spotted by farmers who in turn informed the Forest Department AMN Shiva, Forest Range Officer Puruvampatti range said that the snake was caught by anti-poaching watchers. It was later released in a reserve forest area near Kovai Kutralam. Officials said that the snake could have come to the agricultural land through the stream. Unhygienic conditions, lack of facilities plague Uravar Sandai. The RS Puram Uravar Sandai, established by the government to facilitate direct selling of agricultural produced by the farmers to the end consumers without the interference of middlemen, is plagued by inadequate infrastructure, underutilization or non-utilization of existing facilities such as vermicompost yards and buildings and mounting garbage. Mr. Paraniswamy, District Secretary, Tamil Nadu, Vivasayagal Sangam said that they had faxed a memorandum to the special cell of the Chief Minister to streamline the functioning of the RS Puram Uravar Sandai. The authorities took initiative to renovate the stinking toilets and clean the vermicompost pits for early revival after the Sangam has petitioned the collector recently. Indians again top foreign property investors in Dubai. Indians bought property worth rupees 42,000 crore in Dubai from January 2016 to June 2017. This is an increase of rupees 12,000 crore from 2014 when the department recorded Indian buyers investing rupees 30,000 crore that year. This was more than a quarter of total sales of rupees 1 lakh crore of non-Arab property investment in 2014. While selecting the property type, apartments were most preferred, with villas following at 17%. Dubai property market is highly regulated and safeguards interest of buyers, tenants and landlords. We'll resume back after a short break.
I'm ready. Polama.
Ipreva. கோவிலுக்கா? கோவிலுக்கு எப்பவுமே ட்ரெடிஷ்னலா வேஷ்டி கட்டிட்டு தான் வரணும். ரூம்ல ராம்ராஜ் பாக்கெட் வேஷ்டி வச்சிருக்கேன். ஆம்பளையா லட்சணமா கட்டிட்டு வாங்க.
வெண்மையில் தரிசனம் வேண்டுதல் நம் வசம்.
இங்க இது கோவில்.
ஓ சாரி.
செல்போன வேஷ்டி பாக்கெட்ல வைங்க. வேண்டுதல மனசுல வைங்க.
ராம்ராஜ் நெக்ஸ்ட் வெல்க்ரோ பாக்கெட் தோத்திஸ் டெம்பிள் கலெக்ஷன்ஸ்.
வெல்கம் பேக். 5 minors detained for attack on Swiss couple, raids on to nab others. Uttar Pradesh police detained 5 minors for the brutal attack on a Swiss couple in Fatehpur Sikri that had left them bruised and battered. A 6th accused, most probably also a minor, is absconding. Raids were carried out in some part of Uttar Pradesh to nab him. The trio have been charged under IPC Section 323 and 325. The Uttar Pradesh government and police faced criticism from various quarters the day after the assault, which happened when the couple Quentin Jeremy Clark and Mary Dose were walking around Fatehpur Sikri. Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, who was in Agra, said that the government was committed to safety of tourists. The tourism police from now on will not be restricted to the Taj Mahal alone. We will not be lenient with anyone who misbehaves with tourists in Uttar Pradesh. Our government will formulate a new strategy to provide security. Switzerland great Martina Hingis announced retirement. Swiss great Martina Hingis has announced that she will retire from tennis at the end of this week WTA finals, where the 37-year-old multiple Grand Slam champion is playing in the doubles tournament alongside Taiwan Chang Yang. The retirement will be Hingis' third in a long and illustrious career, during which she claimed 25 Grand Slam titles since her WTA Tour debut in 1994, 5 in singles, 7 in mixed doubles and 13 in women's doubles. Australia edged out India Juniors 4-3 in hockey. India Juniors lost their first match when they were piped 3-4-4 by Australia in a high-scoring fourth-round Robin League encounter at the 7th Sultan of Johor Cup hockey tournament. The defeat came a day after India has armed United States of America 22-0 in their third league encounter. Dilpreet Singh and Sanjay scored for India in the match, but goals from Joel Rintala, Gobi Green, Jonathan Brathorn and Nathan Abhamas were enough for Australia to secure the victory. Australia dominated the proceedings in the initial stages of the first quarter as they attacked the Indian defence to start on a bright note. However, India could only stay level at 3-4-3 for 2 minutes as Australia's Nathan Abhamas converted a penalty corner in the 49th minute to give Australia a 4-3 lead. That's it for the news bulletins. Thank you. Have a nice day.